All right, let's go to Baltimore now, where there was no chance to protest because the city took down Confederate statues in that city overnight. Monuments dedicated to Robert E. Lee and Stonewall Jackson were among the four taken down. This came as pressure is building across this country to remove or relocate Confederate-related statues. One of those very people, Robert E. Lee, is one of the most iconic on the Confederate side. His statue was at the center of last week's violence in Charlottesville. Those monuments memorializing our past now beg a very present question.
And that big question, should Confederate monuments be removed? The long debate over history versus hate is heating up again. Lindsay Sievert went to the Minnesota History Center for some perspective on the monumental problem.
Should the markers of the Confederacy still stand as symbols of heritage or topple as an immortalized reminder of hate?
I wonder, is it George Washington next week, and is it Thomas Jefferson the week after?
The weekend tragedy in Charlottesville throws the role of these lasting monuments into question.
Are there ways we can better interpret the history? Is there better ways we can tell the history?
The Minnesota History Center Museum helps Minnesotans reckon with artifacts from every era.
Kind of crisp that edge up a little bit.
Even today, children witnessed a memorial in the making.
What is the purpose of a monument?
Okay, let me put back on my historian hat. It's for people to remember a time gone by, if that makes sense, especially when you look at the monuments that are all being removed. The majority of them were placed there a good 40 to 50 years after the Civil War. So you're looking at about, 1913 to 1920 during that Jim Crow time period.
Melanie Adams is in charge of guest experiences and education at the Minnesota Historical Society, but has a close connection to Charlottesville.
I went to the University of Virginia for undergrad, so a proud Wahoo. And I think it was really disheartening to see what was happening. You don't think you'd see men walking through torches through your campus.
As cities like New Orleans and now Baltimore have banished Confederate monuments, Melanie believes the decision should be up to each community.
But I will say I'm a firm believer in interpretation over removal.
Take the example of six highly debated Civil War paintings moved from Governor Dayton's office to another spot in the state capitol.
And better interpreted. I think that's the key that people are missing. With proper interpretation, I think there's a way to use a lot of these things as educational resources.
Context, she says, can help understand how history is evolving from one version of events to a modern, inclusive narrative.
The time is right now to have these discussions, but I also want people to consider taking down the monument does not erase history. I think it frustrates me when people say that we're changing history. We're not changing history. History has always been complex, and we've just always chosen to select one side of it.
So as monuments speak to us, she cautions we have to recognize the story they tell and the story we'd like to tell 50 years from now.
What society do we want our children to grow up in? When they're walking to school in the morning, what monuments do we want them to pass along the way? Because the monuments you create show what you're proud of.
Now, the Minnesota History Center staff helped us research if there are any Confederate statues in Minnesota. We just couldn't find any together with all of us, but of course there are Civil War monuments and other references in our region. And I love what Melanie had to say about what monuments do you want to see in the future. And she mentioned women, people of color, Native American community. Who do you want to represent? Strength, courage. And I think that's food for thought for all of us.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that was the point that resonated with me the most, was that what do we want to be proud of? I don't want to walk down Confederate Monument Row and explain to my children. Mm-hmm. I mean, we have to tell them obviously about our history, but I don't know that only those statues are what I want them to see.
Would you prefer to see the statues mm-hmm. in a museum setting, similar to how we see
with
the
context.
Colored whites-only signs? Mm-hmm. We don't really see those signs around anymore. They've been removed.
Mm-hmm. It seems like a safer space when it's no longer relevant to our modern-day narrative.
Yeah. Lots to think about.
Yeah,
thanks for thought.
Circle back.
We're back in a few minutes.